Hi friends, welcome to Gurav YouTube channel. This channel is about education and technological purposes. If you're not subscribed, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. We discuss with the registers. A small number of ultra fast registers are integrated into a CPU for fastest execution. Have the length of the computer board. Intel i7 is a 64-bit wide. I told you, right? Either you want to store the data in the secondary memory, or you want to store the data in the primary memory, or you can store the data in the cache, or you can store the data in the register. Clear? Yes or no? To execute on the faster, go for the register. Later comes in a cache, later comes in a RAM, later comes in a secondary storage, right? Which is the costliest? Consider to here, registers are the costliest to fabricate. Concerned with the secondary memory. Again, RAM is a costly concern with the secondary memory compared to the secondary memory. RAM is a costly. For 4GB RAM, it needs around 1000 to 2000. But for the hard disk, 1 TB of the hard disk can be cost of the 4000. Here, there is a cost-wise comparison. Now here, considering the registers, right? Computers, loads and instruction. Base of the calculation is done by the registers, right? Right. Several registers are existed in the CPU, right? If you are given the instruction for the calculation of a multiplication, right? C is equal to, or addition, C is equal to A plus B. One register will take an A value, one more register will take a B value, and we calculate. Register calculates. After the calculation, ALU unit is doing, right? ALU unit is taking the register's values and we calculate. After the calculation, result will be generated, that is given to the C register, right? In the C program, you are using the C is equal to A plus B line, right? In the instruction execution in the CPU, it will take the help of R1, R2, R3 registers line. R1, R2 talk for the storing of the AB value, R3 for the result storage. Clear? You are given the value for the A and the B in the C program. That will be transferred to the R1 register and to the R2 register. In the CPU, execution happens. After the execution, result will be produced. Result will be given to the register R3. Then R3 is giving the value to the C, then you are printing the C value in the C program. Right. Now next is a secondary memory. Primary memory represents a small amount of the memory, right? And it is a volatile in the nature. Volatile in the nature represents when power goes off, whatever the content are there in the memory will be vanishes, will be erased or will be deleted. But we need a data permanently. Am I right or not? If you consider your any study material and all, that should be stored permanently. Whenever you want, you can access it. For the reason, a secondary memory has got, right? Has developed. Secondary memory, we will call it as a secondary memory, or we will call it as a auxiliary memory, or we will call it as a secondary storage. The three names means the same concept. Okay, next is it's not directly connected to the CPU. Non-volatile, offline or permanent, right? Not directly connected, it is not connecting directly to the CPU. Right, what happens? Secondary storage device occurs, like a hard disk, like a rectangle shape, the hard disk will be available. Later we can connect it to the CPU. But what happens in the RAM? A slot will be given to the particular RAM, just insert the chip there on the port of the motherboard. Then it is connected to the particular CPU, but it is not directly connected. It is not directly connected. It is connected through the buses. It is connected through the wires, connection ports, right? Non-volatile, I told you, it is a permanent one. Non-volatile represent when power goes off, data will be available for you in the next time usage. Clear? That is a non-volatile. Offline or permanent. It is a offline use or a permanent to use. It's a slower compared with the primary memory. Primary memory is a faster one, but compared to that one, secondary memory is a slower. These are all the characteristics. Large capacity. Primary memory is a 4GB, A secondary memory is something like a 1 TB or 500 GB. 4 GB to 500 GB. Very good. It's a large memory, large capacity. Cheaper than primary memory. Means primary memory are costlier, secondary memory are cheaper one. Right? Then they given us some different types of secondary memory. Just like giving the hardest is a one example for the secondary memory. Then there are so many examples are there. Hardest. The capacity we can manage it as a 500 GB to 4 TB life. Right? We can say the secondary memory are hardest as a 1 TB, 2 TB, 4 TB life. Right? It's a range of the hardest. Next is a magnetic tape. 20 dB, up to 20 dB we can store in the magnetic tapes. CD-ROM, 700 MB. CD-ROM, compact disc read only memory. CD represent compact disc. ROM represents read only memory. That is a 700 MB. Then a Blu-ray disc. That is something like a similar to the CD only, right? That is a Blu-ray disc. That is a 27 GB to the 50 GB of storage. External device. It is external device. Flash memory. 1 GB to 128 GB. Obsolete floppy disk is a 1.2 MB and 1.4 MB. The two variations they given, right? In the two different ways, the floppy can be available. First example, hard disk. A rectangle surface. Second one, magnetic tape. Magnetic tape is similar to that of a particular cassette. In earlier days, looking with a cassette which can be inserted into a what do you call it as? Tape record. The cassettes are available. That would be, it is in that form only. Magnetic tape is in that form only. That is nothing but 20 TB. CD, you know regarding CD, right? Each and every movie is copied into the CD and it is given to the user to see. That is a CD. It is a 700 MB, right? It is a 700 MB. DVD comes there, one more. It is in the much richer as that of the CDs, right? Flash memory represent pen drive or your SD card memory storage. In the cameras, the SD cards are inserted. That's a flash memory. Floppy disk. Floppy disk represents again something like a rectangle shape, right? But a small magnetic unit is present in the center of that particular thing. Clear? Floppy disk. I have a diagram for that. Okay, don't worry. Hard disk, right? Hard disk for a hard drive or a fixed drive. It's a secondary storage which is having a high capacity, right? It is a cheaper cost, which is used in our laptops and desktops to have a 500 GB up to again 1 TB, right? Again a 2 TB hard disk are also available, 4 TB hard disk are also available. You can go through the diagrams, right? It's the arm parts here. This is the head, right? Some platters. It's a cylindrical like structure. There is a cylindrical like structure. Sectors are there. Again, here are the platters, right? These represent here. This is a detailed diagram. It's a what you say compressed diagram, right? Okay, these are the parts associated with the what you call it as a the hard disk, right? Hard disk. Heads, cylinder, sectors, platters, right? Hard disk, right? How the hard disk will work, they given here. Every disk contains a spindle that holds one or more platters, right? A spindle is like something like a cylinder like a shape. There is a spindle which is holding there. A platters made up of a non-magnetic materials, right? Platters are nothing but a non-magnetic materials. How they are hold the data represents it. If there is a magnetic material, if it is exposed, then the zeros, one and we can store in the magnetic field, right? That is widely used, right? In the huge storage, we are using a magnetic concept there, right? It is exposed to the something like a rays, like using a UV rays or a lights, or say current voltage passing there, which can burn the zeros and one produced there in the magnetic fields, and that is representing the storage. Clear?
platters made up of non-magnetic materials, right? Aluminium or glass, right?
That is not holding, right?
Platters are nothing but here you are represented there. Each platter have a two surfaces. Each platters are having a two surface, right? Coated with a magnetic material.
Platters are made up of a glass or aluminium. On that platter, it is covered with a magnet. Okay? Platters are not made up of a magnet, but it is covered with a magnetic surface, right? Then if you want to store the data there, some heads should be rotated on that. Which one the data should be stored properly? The heads are rotating on that particular platter, the data will be stored there.
Each platter have a two surface coated with a magnetic material. Information is encoded on this platter surface.
Means wherever the magnet surface is there we are storing the data.
Okay? Which is using the help of the heads.
Heads represent which are covered with there. Whenever which space you want, the rotations occur there. Right? Rotations of the cylinders occur there. Depending on the rotations, the heads will be made of magnetic materials to store the data or encode the data. Okay? Where you are storing the data in this particular diagram? On the surface of platter, which is having the magnetic material. On the surface of the platter, which is having magnetic material. By the use of heads.
There is a head on head representation.
By using the heads, you are storing the data there.
Concentrating and serial number track, right? Serial number tracks are there, you can see here. The tracks are made there. The tracks are made there. Smaller one, bigger one, the tracks are made there. Sorry. Concentrating and serial numbered tracks. Tracks are made there in a cylinder. Tracks on the surface, right? These are tracks on the surface. It is nothing but a platter magnetic coated there. Then they are making that as a track broken up into a sectors or a block. Each and every track is broken into a sectors. In the above one cylinder, is a sectors are there, right? A cylinder, a sectors are there. In the sense that a circular form is there, which is mean for some circles, right? Concentric circles. Within the circles, they are making it as a sectors. They are making it as a sectors there, right? Each track which is having a 32 blocks, right? Each track, whatever the round circle, the round circle is there, it is made up of 32 blocks. Each block is again made up of with a disc have a 8 surfaces. If we consider 32 blocks with the 8 surfaces, 256 blocks per cylinder. If we consider one cylinder, how many cylinders are there in the left hand side? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 cylinders are there. For considering each and every cylinder, what's the cost here? 256 blocks in a particular cylinder have been framed there. And a block which is comprises of 512 bytes. Clear? 256 blocks made in a per cylinder. A block comprises of 512 bytes. Then you can multiply the 512 into 256, then we calculate the data which is stored on a particular cylinder. So many cylinders have made there in a hard, right? To store the data. Disk spins, right? To store the data, the disk should be spins there, right? If you start your computer, some voice or the sound comes there from your computer. That is a to store the data, then the hard disk should be rotated there. The cylinder should rotate there. Then only the data will be stored. What is the speed there? 5400. It's a 1. Depending on the computer, the speed is changing there. 5400. Again, one more variation is 7200 RPM. What is my RPM? In the minute, how many rotations occur? Right? In a 1 minute, how many rotations occur? It is a speed calculated there. Disk heads move radically.
The disk heads, what I told here, they move radically to expose the material which is on the platters, right?
Disk heads move radically from track to track. What is a track? You can see here. Platters are there, a circles are there. The round surface, or say the round mark, what they made there, that's a track made, right? Cylinder is there. You can see here. These are the tracks made, right? In the running 400 meter relay, the tracks have been made, is it not? Yes or no? What the sectors have? If we consider this portion, we consider it as a sector. This is the sector, right? These are the tracks. These are the tracks, right? Disc head. What is the disc head here? Here in the disc head, yeah. In the right hand side, it is visible. The disc head moves radically around the particular cylinder to store the data there. From track to track and store the data or retrieve the data. To store represent, to burn the data on the particular hard disk. Or to read just, it should be reflected particular things from the data, which is stored already, right? Reading and writing are done there, right? In a summarize, to say a hard disk which is made up of so many cylinders like a structure. Each cylinder which is having with us what we call it as tracks. Tracks have been broken as a sectors, right? Platters is a glass or aluminum like structure which is made up there with a cylinder. On the platter, the magnetic material is covered there, right? Then if we start the computer also to read or to write on the disk, the cylinder should rotate with each other with a specified rotation speed here, RPM. Whenever it is rotating, the heads, whatever there on the particular cylinder, will be placed on that particular cylinder to read or to write. Okay? The data is stored on the magnetic material of that platter. Where the data are stored? The data are stored on the magnetic material of that particular platter.
To read that.
Next is a magnetic tape, right? Magnetic tape, I told you, right? The magnetic tape is nothing but something like cassettes in the earlier days available, right? Similar things can be used in the computer board to store the data, clear?
Tape is made up of a plastic film with one side coated with a magnetic material, right?
Whatever you want to store, there should be a magnetic material, clear?
Two spool. What do you mean by spool?
In the cassettes, two cylinder like structures are there. One is moving in the clockwise, right? Then the other will be driving there. Am I right or not? To listen to the song, the cassette should play there. Whenever it is playing, two spins are rotating there to cover that particular song, right?
There is a spin. Two spools
represent the cylinder of say round like structures are available that we call it as a spool.
Tape is encapsulated in a small cassette.
A tape is encapsulated in a small cassette, right? A small cassette, which is a plastic material,
or cartridge. Currently, in the computer world, 1 TB of the data can be stored by using a magnetic tape.
Then you can Google the internet to see the diagram of the magnetic tape. It is like a cassette like a structure.
In the computer world, they are using.
In the future, 200 TB can be stored by using a magnetic tape.
Not fully portable because a separate tape drive is needed, right?
If you want a CD to play, we are inserting the CD into a computer. CD drive or DVD drive is needed. Drive is needed. Similarly, magnetic tape drive should be needed in the computer. But nowadays, in our computer, we are not having that drive. Right?
CD drive in my laptops, you can see there. It's a DVD drive. Just if I place there, it is open. Right? It's a DVD drive.
CD drive.
I will place the CD here, just I will
press it, the CD will be playing here, or DVD will be playing. But we are not having a magnetic tape drive. Right? The cassette like structure we cannot insert it. Right? It is not fully portable. Portable represent? What do you mean by portable? Can be carried. Your watch can be carried
bag can be carried anywhere, right? Portable means we can carry it anywhere, but it is not fully portable. Magnetic tape is not fully portable.
Clear? Next is a optical disc, CD-ROM, DVD-ROM, Blu-ray disc, right?
These are all like a cylinder like a structure. CD has the loop, right? CD, DVDs.
They are non-volatile. Non-volatile represent if you burn into a CD, they are non-volatile.
If the power goes off, data will be remains there in the CD.
Read-only memory, right?
Is it a read-only memory? Can we write in there? We can write. Right? We can write. As we purchase, there is no data in the particular thing. Then you have to burn it. If you burn, then the data will be available in the CD, then you can read only, right? You can read only. But some DVDs are there, you can write multiple times there. Not so much like 10,000 times. Just a small amount of time you can write also.
Okay. Range is 700 MB. 700 MB represent it is a CD compact disc.
But then to say 4.7 GB to say 4.7 GB is a DVD capacity. A normal usable DVD capacity is a 4.7 GB. Right?
Up to 8.5 GB you can use it.
In the sense that much of capacity can be there in the CD or a DVD form.
Next is a Blu-ray capacity, right? Blu-ray is nothing but other way.
In the series that, something like colored, you will observe the colors, different colors of it. But here, you know, Blu-ray disc represent, again it is something like a CD only, but the color is a blue because it holds a much capacity of the data.
Right, like something like a 50 GB of the data, it will hold. Again, this is something, a disc-like structure. Laser beam in their drivers controls head read and write operation. Laser beam is needed there to read and write of that particular Blu-ray, right?
Whenever I will insert any series, no? The rotations occur there. Laser beam has exposed on that particular CD plate. Reflected rays will be calculated, then that will be converted into a data to see the movie option to see the document. CD insert, it will rotate. Head is there. It exposes a laser beam. Right? Reflected laser beam can be calculated and that will be given to the computer to see the data or to watch the movie if you are inserting the movies, right? Laser beam is needed here.
To control the read and write operation, personal computers and laptops are having this driver, right? As I told here, it's a driver.
We are having a driver,
right? Data backup is also easy, right? Backup represents copy and paste.
Whatever you are inserting the CD, no? We can copy the content from the CD and we can paste in our desktop or laptops, right?
That's the backup of the data. Optic discs are made up of a carbonate materials with a thin layer or two of the reflective films. Laser beam is used to construct up pits and lines by burning it, right?
Whenever we will purchase, that's an empty. Insert it, burn it first. Right? Neuro is a software is used to burn the CD or DVD. Neuro software. Right? Nowadays, many of the computers are directly they are burning. But a neuro software which is used to better burn the, whenever it is burning, in the sense that pits and the lines,
pits represent, they, I given there. Zeros and one represents, right? Lands represent one, pits represent zero. There in the last paragraph, last line. Pits represent one, but not from.
Pits represent zero, land represent one. I told you computer to understand zeros and one, right? That should be given in the CD or DVD, right?
Whenever it will burn, it is burn according to the pits and the lands, right?
Pits represent 0, lands represent 1.
Select areas along its track. In the sense that tracks have been formed there also, right?
In the CD, in a hard disk also, tracks have been formed. In a CD or a DVD, a disk, tracks have been formed there, right? Tracks have been formed depending on the pits and the lands, right? Pits represent 0, lands represent 1.
When reading the data, the beam is reflected from a lamp but not from the fixed, right?
In the sense that if you want to read which is using, lamp is using instead of a fixed, right? Once whatever it is reflected from the disk, we are calculating it and we are reading the data.
CDR, the variations are given there.
CDR represents a read only, compact disk, a read only. DVDR represents the DVD disk only for the reading purposes, right? One time if you are written, that's over. Here also manufacturer have been are writing this one. In the sense that Windows 7 CD if you brought genuine the Windows 7 CD, it is already burned CD will be provided. Also burned DVD will be provided there. You need not to burn one more time. Clear? That is a read only. Whenever you purchase any CD for particular songs, right? It's already burned there giving you. It's a read only, right?
CD, read and write, represent,
you purchase it, you write it, again you can read it, right?
DVD,
read and write, right? In the sense that, so if you are burned in the data, again you can burn one more time there, it is also possible. That is, again, in the sense that,
variation of the CD and DVD are given.
CD read, CD write, DVD read, DVD read write. R represents read write.
That is an optical disc.
Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe to this channel and post your suggestion in the comment box.